from Pastor John's message was just seeing each other and seeing ourselves from how God sees us. And then Uncle Tyler mentioned, you know, how we are. What I heard was, you know, we are like the ones. We have just so much blessing and so much opportunity, knowing true parents. And I was thinking, you know, well, how does God, you know, if God was here looking through me and looking at you, how would God look at everybody? And the first thing I thought about was how unworthy I am as a pastor here, and you know, I'm just been, you know, not doing enough, or not being, you know, I realize that I've been, you know, I have a lot of, you know, I have expectations of, you know, of you, or expectations of myself, judgments of myself this morning. So I'm for those of you that don't know, I'm doing this program. It's all about transforming who you are, and with more, you know, to have more power and freedom in your life. And this morning I was not feeling very free or powerful coming here, because I was kind of worried that I didn't prepare enough for, how to inspire, you know, how to share and inspire all of you. And so I actually have a coach in my program, and I was like, Coach, you know, I called my coach, her name is Jamie Lee. I said, Jamie Lee, you know, I'm feeling disempowered. I'm planning to give a sermon today. and, you know, I don't know how I'm going to inspire or share God's words. I don't know what I'm going to do. And then I also said to her, like, I guess I, you know, myself, and she says, so why are you calling me? And then I said, well, my selfish reason for calling is because I want to be, like, inspired, and I want to feel better. And she was like, Josh, you know, what are you talking about? Like, if you want to, like, God wants you to feel good. You don't have to, you think that that's selfish, like, to feel that you want to be inspired and you want to feel empowered. And I just realized that, you know, that's kind of everywhere. You know, I have all of these judgments about, oh, I'm not good enough, or, oh, I'm selfish because I want to be, you know, because I'm calling to get support, to be, you know, to be more inspiring or be inspired. And yeah, God doesn't, I don't know, it's just great. It's just really, I didn't even think about what she said, that you know, I'm judging myself for wanting to be powerful and wanting to be inspiring and inspire myself, and that, yeah, God wants us to all be empowered and inspired and happy and, you know, free, or, you know, all of that. So it's really not selfish. And what else did she say? She said something that, oh, she said, whatever you love is what is God's will. You know, what you love, or what you, you know, what kind of, how I heard it was, what you want is what God wants, and God's will as well. And I was like, yeah, I just felt, you know, just remembered that God, you know, we really judge ourselves and judge others. I know that I judge others and myself a lot, but God just wants us to be happy and wants us to be, you know, free and authentic with each other, or authentic with ourselves. And I'm the one that's thinking that that's a problem. So Yeah, anyways, I'm practicing being authentic, so I wanted to share that. And yeah, I just, you know, today I woke up, I don't know, around 6, and I was just reading about, you know, what have been mother's words recently, what's going on really in our movement. You know, honestly, I try to read some articles or some things that are happening and just to keep on track, but today I was looking like, you know, how can I share, you know, mother's heart or mother's words or true parents' words? And I just saw about Dr. Kim. I don't know if any of you saw, but Dr. Kim shared at a national leaders meeting, in monthly meeting that they have in New Jersey, and he shared about Madison Square Garden, you know, and how much mother wants to be here, mother wants to be with us, how much of an opportunity it'll be for us to be with her. And there was people that gave some testimonies, and I was reminded of, again, Uncle Tyler. We were having dinner together, and he shared about how True Father loves people. He loves testimonies that are like just from the heart, you know, like just kind of free and just sharing, you know, just sharing of ourselves. And he said, what was it about? You asked True Father one time, how long should I talk, or how long should I be sharing about something? And then True Father said, you can talk forever. I guess, you know, what I'm sharing is really about, like, how I want to see our community, like, what I want to see in our community is that kind of, like, freedom to be, you know, real and connected with each other, like, just like sharing what's on our heart, sharing and like being willing to listen forever, you know, like True Father was said, you know, if, and also I think when we do that, my experience has been when someone is really, you know, sharing what they're really dealing with or what's really, really important to them, like the essence of what's important to them, you kind of lose track of time. So, you know, that's really one of the things I wanted to share as well, is like what I'm like committed to creating here in our community, that kind of just connection and sharing and I guess authenticity as well. And I think that also with Madison Square Garden, with sharing, one of the things that Dr. Kim was talking about was inviting guests to come as well, and to, you know, bring guests, and of course come ourselves, and I was just thinking like how powerful it is to, you know, what I've seen in my, you know, my program that I'm doing, you know, this leadership, transformational leadership program that I'm doing, it's, a lot of it is, talks about sharing authentically, and I've seen how, you know, how it, that's all that people want to hear, like, nobody wants to hear my, I don't know, like, my canned, whatever, sales pitch maybe about the movement, or, what I think, you know, how I think it would benefit them or something like that, but really, like, how it's changed, how it's affected, you know, how it's affected my life, or how, like, this thing that I've been dealing with that I really, like, you know, for, I don't know, like, maybe my relationship with my wife, for example, that's, like, so important to me, so, sometimes so difficult, and how, like, True Parents, how, you know, whatever has made a difference there, like, that's what people want to hear. So I was also thinking, you know, what if we could bring that here with, you know, I think first really with each other, to be to share with each other authentically, that'll really, I can see that creating like this kind of connection where we come to Sunday and, you know, we're just, well, today I was just going to talk about you, I'm sharing. A few days ago, I called on Sharon. We were just sharing about, you know, many things that I was worried about, things that I, you know, I had, well, been actually judging her about. And I just shared with her, and I told her, like, that's not what I want in our relationship. I want us to be like, you know, this family, all of us here, like us be like this team, you know, we're gonna really make a difference in North Carolina. And then after that, when I came here on Sunday, I was just like, I'm sure it's great to see you, like wanted to give her a hug. I don't think I gave you a hug every Sunday. So, you know, that's what I want to create, like where we can share like that with each other, where we feel like we come in on Sunday, you know, Gail knows what I'm, you know, dealing with or what's really important to me, and I share with her freely. And then when we're here, we're just so happy to see each other because that's the kinds of relationships that we have. And I feel like what was my second point? I had a second point. I think that's the same thing that we could also do with anybody that we'd like to share with about your parents, or maybe inviting them to Madison Square Garden, or you know whatever it is. That's basically the main kind of area that I want to share about today is sharing together authentically, being not just that, but also kind of being willing to really take responsibility for where we've been, you know, not real with each other, or where we've been, you know, for me, a big thing is being judgmental. That's a big thing for me. So taking responsibility for that, bringing that up and resolving that. Square Garden and what your mother and Dr. Kim are talking about. Let's see. Oh, right, there we go. We got a flyer. Thank you. So we got some this is called a flyer. What is it? No, this is called it. This size paper.
Highest quality flyer I've ever put my hands on.
Yeah.
That paper, you
can
go into the bathroom with it and take it into the shower.
Headquarters made them.
Headquarters made them. I guess one thing that I want to mention is, you know, how I think sometimes we forget how much people are wanting what we have, you know, what our true parents have, you know, what our true parents have shared with us. We're not perfect, and we don't have things figured out. We're not really following what our true parents are teaching. I mean, at least we're following, but we're definitely not there yet. And how much has it still changed our lives, and how much could it for others? And yeah, I don't know. I mean, like, you know, some, I guess in, at first I didn't really think that. I didn't really think that people really cared that much about, you know, knowing about our movement or knowing about True Parents, but I mean, peace, you know, peace starts with me. I mean, who doesn't want to have peace and in their life and their families? I mean, how many people are not dealing with like this divided culture? And you know, I don't know, maybe all of you think that everybody needs it, you know, so maybe it's just me that I was thinking that. But you know, people are out there that are just kind of, they're waiting, you know, they're like, not maybe not waiting, but they're yearning for something, you know, they're yearning for our message and our, you know, our truth and, you know, what, for True Parents, really, I mean, what an amazing example, you know, what amazing. How many, you know, I know my parents, you know, my parents, they're missionaries in, you know, they've been missionaries in Afghanistan and different places. And they were, you know, they were the only members sometimes. And sometimes, you know, when they're, I mean, when they have a fight with each other, you know, all they have at that point, since they don't have each other anymore, is, you know, True Parents and God. And I mean, it's like you can always go look at True Parents for what they've done, how they've gone through something. You know, they've gone through everything. They, you know, I was thinking, so, you know, this program that I'm doing, it's pretty awesome. And anyways, I was, Homare was gone for a weekend and I was with the kids. And I was with the kids for about, you know, 4 days. And, you know, I haven't done that before. John says,
God bless you, man.
Yes. It was like, I thought, it was pretty difficult. So, you know, I've been so inspired by what I've been doing with this program. I really felt like I can, you know, it's really connected to what our True Parents are doing, really to, you know, inspire and empower our people. And I've just seen, like, I've just been so inspired by it. So I was determined to go to one session that we were going to have, and it was in Charlotte. So I had no idea how to do it. And one of the things that I realized that in my life, I've always stopped myself when I don't know how to do something. Like when I think I don't know how to work, I'll just stop. I'll be like, yeah, I can't figure it out, so I'm not even gonna try. You know, I mean, imagine if True Father did that, where would it be? But you know, I don't see how it's gonna work, so you know, I'm just done. You know, because I have to have everything figured out. Like that's one of my things. So I was like, okay, I don't care, you know, even if it's not going to work, or even if nothing works out, I'm going to at least have a breakthrough in that way of thinking. So I'm going to go and drive to Charlotte or do something and attend the session, even if I don't have it figured out. You know, if I don't have a babysitter, main thing with babysitter, right? So anyways, we went to Chick-fil-A, we got food for them, and anyways, we started driving, and I started thinking, like, I came to a point where I was, like, getting a bit tired, you know, and obviously, you know, that's pretty dangerous if you're on the road and you're tired, so I was thinking, like, you know, I can't keep going because I'm tired and this is dangerous and, you know, I need to go home. So I ended up turning around and going home after like driving for about half an hour or something like that.
You were on the way to Charlotte?
Yeah. So, but I thought about True Father at that moment, you know, because I was really trying to go. Like I was calling people, trying to see how it would work out. I called that Jamie Lee, you know, my, my coach, Jamie Lee. I was like trying to get some support. And I, at that moment, I was thinking like, I'm doing everything that I can. Like I'm willing to, you know, sacrifice being uncomfortable and not eating well and lack of sleep and dealing with the kids on the road and all of these things. And I'm like, I was like, how do I do this? How can I make it work? And I was like, I can't, you know, it's too dangerous. I literally might die, you know, if I go. So I'm just gonna turn around. And then I thought about True Father and I was like, True Father, he went till he might die. You know, he knew that he probably would die. Or not only that, like not only was he at that level, but he was even at the level of, you know, level of sacrificing his life, but not only that, even sacrificing his children, right? I mean, he really did sacrifice his children. We were just kind of hitting on that last night. And how much I'm not at all even close to that, you know. And then I thought, not only is True Father willing to do that, to sacrifice his life, but he even had to make it work without dying. He couldn't even die. Like, even, he's like, it has to work, and I can't die. You know, it'd probably been easier if he could have died for him. So, you know, that was, just made me think, like, how far away I am from True Father, but, you know, not really in a bad way, but, you know, that's just the privilege of the person that we know, and you know, that's something that, you know, we can share with people, you know, in our lives, you know, just keep in mind for ourselves, you know, that how many people in history, you know, have been like true parents, you know? Even if you just look at the physical aspect of things, you know. I shared that with Omar, and it's been great, you know, going through these different kinds of experiences, pushing myself.
Did you make it to Charlotte?
No, I didn't. So I decided to turn around after like half an hour driving and just came back. Yeah, because I was thinking, yeah, I might be, this is dangerous, and I'm not willing to die for it. I'm not willing to die for what I believe. I mean, you know, kind of what it comes down to. I've had the same experience when I was in the same thing, same thoughts on the champion. I was thinking, you know, about, I don't know how I got to that point, but I just realized, like, I'm not willing to sacrifice my life. I'm not willing to sacrifice my family. And I also had a feeling of, what if I could, what if I was at that? You know, what if I was like that? Just kind of, I remember wanting to have that, actually. What kind of life, actually, I think it would be a very amazing, inspiring life. I mean, like, imagine if, I mean, I imagine that first generation have experienced that, you know, you were so alive and so excited that you sacrificed your family, you know, you sacrificed sometimes your life, or willing to sacrifice your life, and I imagine it's kind of exciting. Was that exciting to be with your spouse, both of you on that page? You know, maybe sometimes you weren't, but anyways, many, you know, those couples that were, you know, in it together, like, we're both willing to. Yeah, I don't know. Did any of you have that kind of experience?
More like your experience.
More like mine. I'm not willing to die.
Well, willing, but maybe God's saying not yet or not now.
Oh, okay. Wow. Who's feeling like they're not really willing to sacrifice a lot of things?
That's the problem.
Well, we were all sort of participating in Father doing that.
That's right.
Because it wasn't just jumping out here, you know, hung on and all that. It's all the way to the end. And the key point is that, like you said, you know you're going to die, or that you definitely could die. But you can't turn back. You know you can't turn back. And so you just go forward, and that's, and because if it's really God's will, then God will save you. Or God will make you not die.
Yeah.
And that's where you meet God.
It's your faith.
At the point where you're going to die.
Yeah.
But then the issue of sacrificing children is even much, much deeper than that.
Yeah.
Much more,
much more deep.
You know, multi-layered than that. Anyway, good point you're making. So you make it.
I'm curious. I heard like what you said, like kind of like a following, like a inspired, and kind of you started to follow True Father, and then you're like, okay, now I can't turn back. Like, what do you mean? Do you mean like you could, like you've already started, so you're gonna keep going, or what did you mean by that?
Yeah. I mean, you don't have to. You keep making that decision,
mm-hmm.
to go or not to go.
Yeah.
And I mean, it's a constant choice. And Father would always be upping the ante, making it more difficult.
Yeah.
You thought you did everything, and now, oh no, now this comes. Now this comes.
But I think, Josh, also the first generation, we had, when we went the distance, or we were willing to give our lives, we met God, and our faith got bigger, and we have testimonies and deep experiences, some of us dreams, you know, that we went that distance, but we went beyond what we thought we were capable of doing,
mm-hmm.
and we offered it to God and true parents, and amazing things happen, because
right.
we let it go, and that's why God in this equation is so important in this relationship. And true parents. That's
mm-hmm.
what we have, so different than the outside world.
Mm-hmm.
So a lot of us have incredible little things that we hold on to when we're losing our faith,
mm-hmm.
that we met God.
Yeah.
Dreams and experiences that we'll never forget,
mm-hmm.
that keeps us holding on.
I think it's, for me, it's important to remember that it wasn't really me doing it, it was really true parents doing it.
Mm-hmm.
But because we had discovered and came to understand or to know that true parents are the Messiah, and we said to ourselves, we're going to follow them no matter what. That's what it means. We couldn't turn back.
Mm-hmm.
So once we held on to Father, it was like it was no longer, and yet we had the same fears and doubts and worries, but we didn't make the decision to die ourselves. True parents had already made that for us, and so they brought us with them. So in a way, it was easier for us in that sense. And also, you know, God, I don't know if God wants you and your children to die to go to some seminar, but the point you're making is obviously very clear. You're learning a lesson about that.
Right.
But for us, you know, honestly, it wasn't because we were so great. It was because True Father was so great, and we had, you know, it's like this phrase, once you put your hands to the plowshare, you don't let go.
Mm-hmm.
So Father gave us the experience
mm-hmm.
of people who would sacrifice their lives, even though we probably wouldn't have done that by ourselves.
Mm-hmm.
But because we were with him, we have that experience.
Yeah, what I think hearing from that is like, the power of the subject part, like the subject partner, you know, the power of the leader, or, you know, it's like, and I've been saying that a lot in my life, it's like, if I change in my relationship, automatically she like responds to that, you know, and yeah, we, you know, it's not what I'm hearing is, you know, true father just so amazing, inspiring, and sacrificed that, you know, it's just easy almost, you know, it's just natural and almost, not easy, but natural that, you know, you can keep going and you can just follow and follow. And now what I've seen is we are becoming the subjects, you know, we're getting more, we have more and more, you know, less of true fathers saying, okay, do this, well, you know, less of true parents saying, do this or do this or do this, but a lot of like, okay, figuring out on our own. And what if we could be people for others, you know, for our family, for others like that, then we could we could make it natural for them to, I don't know, whatever you want to make, whatever you want them. Okay, so, yeah.
I just remembered something that when I was pioneering, I used to carry these like speeches or certain key things that Ali would say. And one of the things he said, and I never forgot it, was that, you know, I never really worried so much about the outcome of what I was trying to achieve, but how much effort, where I was giving my 100% effort, you know, to, and even though he didn't know how it would eventually turn out, he didn't worry about that. He just worried about whether he was giving 100%, you know, effort. And I always thought about that because God always took care of him in the end.
Yeah.
And when you find yourself in that kind of situation, if you're, there's a certain power and a certain energy that comes from being aligned with true parents for God's will. And even though you don't know what the future holds in front of you, there's just a kind of a spiritual power that pushes you forward. And when you have those experiences, then your faith becomes deep.
Yeah.
You know, I think this, you never really know what the final outcome is going to be. But if your heart is in the right place, then you have this certain confidence in the future going forward.
Wow. Awesome. Has anybody experienced that experience where you just, you know, you are just doing your, you know, giving your 100%, and you have a certain, you know, you're giving your 100%, and you don't know how it's going to work or what's the outcome going to be. And then you have amazing, you know, your faith becomes deeper, or you have some deep experience, you know, just spiritual support. Great. So, conclusion. You know, I think, you know, 3 points is, you know, let's kind of let go of not knowing how we're going to do things and do that, do, like Tim said, you know, just give our, just put in, you know, the effort, take the next step that we see that we can take, even if that means asking for help. And that's one. So let's give our, put in, how did you say it?
Give it
100% effort. And then the second point is let's be authentic and, you know, with each other here and with others as well, you know, really share what we really care about, what really is important to us with each other. And then the third point is like the power of true father as that subject partner, and how can we be that in our life? How can we take responsibility in our life for whatever? And, you know, could be with, you know, guests or members, or could not members, or could be with our family, you know, with our wife. So let's take all of that, let's take that on this week. Being, you know, giving our 100%, being authentic, and be subject partner in our lives.
Amen.
And that means not dominating, right? That means taking responsibility and setting the example. Okay, please join me for, or let's pass the basket. We don't have a piano, so I'll just sing.
Oh, no.
Are we going to show the weekly update?
Yeah, after I pray, we'll show the weekly update. Any other, anything else to share while we're passing the basket? Yeah, what did you say to Tim? Did you just remind him about that?
About what?
I mean, yeah.
You saw that, right?
I did.
No, because sometimes he's got something to say, and he doesn't say it, he won't bother. So I said, we have to speak up.
How did you know that he had something to say?
Because I do.
Wow.
I just do.
Amazing. Fourth point, let's have that kind of connection. All right. Awesome. Well, thank you. Thank you, Bob. All right, please join me in prayer. Heavenly parents, true parents, thank you for this morning, this beautiful day outside and inside as well. Thank you for all the beautiful families here, Heavenly parents. Heavenly parents, when you look at us, Sometimes when we look at ourselves, we see, you know, mud, or we see this, you know, these, all of our flaws. But when you look at us, you just see our shining, radiant light. Heavenly parents, thank you for that. Thank you for your love. And this morning, we ask that you, we offer our tithing and our donations to you, and we offer this time together, this message. Help us to go out and be connected and authentic to each other, and take responsibility and be the subject partner like our true father and true mother, and really give our 100% in our lives this week. And I offer all this and all this time with all of our families here. And I pour this in the name of Joshua, Mother Angelucci, a blessed central family. Amen.